Hey, this is Brock Lemires, and we're continuing our study of embedded systems design. We have switched over to the C programming language in this chapter, and we are looking at the timer system on the MSP430 FR2355. In this video, we're going to look at using a timer compare, and specifically a timer compare on CCR0, which has a special function. Okay, so remember what a timer compare is you have a register that's called the CCR register, and that stands for capture compare register. And the two C's represent that there's two different modes you can use this register for. One is a compare, which is what we're doing. The other is a capture, which is not what we're doing. And the idea of a compare register is that you configure the counter, and when the counter value equals the number that you put in the compare register, a flag will assert. And the reason that this is important is because it allows us to get a finer precision or accuracy on the amount of time that we're going to count. When we only use timer overflows, what happens is that we're kind of limited in terms of the timer overflow periods because they're always a multiple of 2 to the n. So you do have some settings here. It's like you can, you know, if you have a 16-bit counter, it overflows at 2 to the 16. And you can change the clock frequencies to change the overflow period. You can also, there's some ability to divide the clock to get down, and then you can change the length of the clock. But it's not like you can just walk up to it and say, I want exactly 0.5 seconds. So you just can't get a precise number. So that's what a compare gives us. What we do is we say, you know what? I'm going to calculate a number that represents the exact amount of time that I want, and then I'll let the counter count up to it, and when it reaches it, it will assert a flag. And the flags associated with the compare registers are a different flag than the one associated with overflow. Okay, so in this situation, let's create something that generates a amount of time that's equal to 0.5 seconds or 500 milliseconds. And what we want to do is we want to determine the value to put in the compare register. So that depends on a couple of different things. You still have some choices to make. You have to choose what the clock frequency is. And so generally when you do, I don't know, larger things, like, I mean, we're talking 0.5 seconds, if you're doing a second, couple of seconds, you typically use A clock because A clock's slower. If you're trying to generate events that are really fast, like 50 milliseconds, then you got to flip over and use SM clock, which is 100 or 1 megahertz. And so for this situation, we're going to choose A clock, 32 kilohertz. We'll leave the prescalers at divide by 1, and let's just leave it in 16-bit mode, and let's see what happens. So now when you look at your equation, you have the overflow is always determined by the period of the clock times the number of counts. But in this situation, we are trying to find the number of counts. So we actually plug in 0.5 for the overflow period, and then we divide it by the period of the clock, which is simply 1 over 32k. And when you do that, you solve for the value n, and in this example, it's 16,384. So that's it. So then if I put this value, if I configure the timer with this clock and I put this value in the compare register, when it gets up to this value, it will assert a flag. And that's the general functionality of a compare. Now, on the MSP430, the CCR0 has a special function. Remember, timer B0, B1, and B2 each have 3 capture-compare registers. Timer B3 actually has 7 capture-compare registers. All of them, though, have their CCR0 register with special functionality. Here's the functionality, if you remember. When the counter is in up mode, this not only generates a flag when it hits this value, it actually it sets the counter back to 0. So it sets the maximum value that the counter will count up to, and then it overflows. So it's a special function. You have to think about it like that. If it's not in continuous mode, what would happen is that it would count up, and when it hit this mode or hit this number, 16,384, it would assert this flag, the CCIF flag. But then the counter would just keep going, and it would go up to FFFF and roll over. But if I put it in up mode, then when it hits this value, it'll actually roll to 0 and start over again. So we can use this as like a time, it's really a an overflow bounding thing. So anyway, that's it. It's awesome. Well, let's do it. All right, fire up. One more thing. Let's do an example where we obviously toggle LED one again, but it's going to happen at 0.5 seconds. So it's going to be on our terms. The interrupts that are fired in this situation, notice that we're not using the overflow anymore. We're using capture compare flags. And since CCR0 has such a special function, it actually gets its own dedicated vector address. So it's called timer0_b0_vector. So this is a big deal here. I mean, look at all these other guys I had to share. That's how special CCR0 is. Okay. All right, here we go. Let's do an example. All right, so we're going to code this up. We're going to toggle LED 1 at, oh my gosh, file new CCS. All right, here we go. Okay, so I got my thing. I'm going to call this timer again. Timers, and then let's call this like a compare, but not just a compare, a CCR0 compare. It's a big deal. Okay, so we go ahead and do that. Main.c. All right, so our main.c skeleton pops up and we're off and running. Okay, so I'm gonna come down here. Hey, we are toggling LED1. That's a port. So guess what? We gotta set up the ports. So first thing I wanna do is set port 1 bit 0, which is LED1, to output. And I use the P1DIR register, and I'm going to do a bitwise OR with a mask called bit 0. Now, where did I get these values? This is a register name that is defined in the header file. This is a mask name that's defined in the header file. And I can use that to make this code readable, and I don't have to remember the absolute address of the port 1 direction register. So life is good. All right, let's go ahead and drive it to a 0. So I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna go clear port 1 bit 0 initially. So it starts out at 0. And how do we clear? We do a bitwise AND. So I'm gonna go ampersand equal tilde bit 0. Why did I tilde? Because I'm gonna AND. So I needed to take this mask, which was 00001, and make it 11110. And the reason I do that is because I want to clear bit position 0. So anything ANDed with a 0 goes to a 0. Anything ANDed with a 1 stays the same. All right, that's really all we need to do. So let's now turn on the digital I/O system. So power monitor 5, control 0, and then I'm going to clear. So I go ampersand equal tilde. The bit mask is lock LPM, so lock low power mode 5, and this is turn on digital I/O. Alrighty. So there we go. We're done there. So the LED is ready to be written to. So now let's do this. Let's set up timer. Okay. So I'm gonna set up the timer system, and here we go. So first and foremost, remember, you always got to write a 1 to TB clear in order to reset the counter. So I'm going to do TB0CTL and bitwise OR in order to set a bit called TBCLR. Okay, so this is going to reset TB0. Now, where did all that come from? First of all, TB clear is a bit mask that happens to be set up to clear a specific bit. And TB0 control is timer B0 control register. And that is where almost every bit we mess with to set up the timer is, okay? All right, so then I'm gonna do, let's choose the clock. Let's put it in up mode. Let's put it in up mode, so we'll mess around with this block right here. So I'm gonna do TB0CTL, and I'm gonna bitwise OR that with, and I'm gonna put it in this mode, MC __up, okay? Put in up mode for CCR, 0. Now, where did this mask come from? Holy cow, that was handy. I had MC __continuous I was using before. Now I found one that just happens to put it in up mode. Well, that came from opening up the header file and checking out what's in there. And let's see, I've got this set there, and we got to do the clock too. So let's do TB0CTL, and then I'm going to do a bitwise OR to set a bit called TBSSEL. __A clock. Okay, so choose a clock, and that's 32K hertz. All right, so I got my timer set up. I cleared it. I set it in up mode. Prescalers, I leave at their default value of divide by one. Counter length, I leave at the default value of 16. I chose A clock. Life is good. All right, so now let's set up, let's see, what are we doing? The timer system is actually still not set up, because guess what we have to do? We have to write to this register right here. TV0CCR0 is the name of the register where I put the value that I want to compare against. So I do this by doing this. TB0CCR0, and all you do is go equals 16384. Okay, so we go set CCR0. Well, pretty self-explanatory there. 384, and boom, we did it. So this is awesome. This is just count up. Everything is great. Now, one thing we haven't done though is set up the interrupt service or the interrupts. So now let's do setup. I want to do a timer compare IRQ. So this is a specific one. Here's what we got to look at. This CCIF flag is the one that we care about. We're not using the overflow flag. We're using the CCIF flag. And so that's the one we need to enable. So now when we get into the interrupts for compares, we have different control registers for every single compare register. So we had the timer B control register configured, all this stuff. And then we go down to not only do we have TB0, CCR0, what we put the value in, we have another control register for this compare. So a lot of control, a lot of functionality you have here. The name of it is TB0, CCTL0. Timer B0, capture control 0. Yep, that's it. In there, we can do a bitwise or to set a bit, which is called CCIE. So this is going to be the local enable for CCR0. Okay? There. All right. Now we got that. Let's go ahead and turn on the maskable interrupt. So I'm going to go enable interrupt and turn purple on me. Thank you. And then enable maskables. And that's the global enable. So I can enable all the maskable interrupts, but only the one that I have the local enable enabled will actually be able to fire an interrupt. And now finally, I'm clearing my flag. So my flag is now TB0, TB0, CCTL0. So this flag for this, so if I look back here, this flag CCIFG, it's in the control register for capture compare register 0. Not this flag. Remember, we're not using the overflow flag, which happens to be in the TB0CTL register. So we're using a different flag, different interrupt. Okay, life is good. TB0CCTL0, and I'm going to clear this, buddy. So clear means ampersand equal tilde, and I happen to have a nice mask set up for me, which is CCIFG. This is going to be clear CCR. It's like CC, it's clear flag. All right, that should do it. That's a lot of setup. These are getting long. A main loop. What do you want to do for the main loop? How about nothing? Let's just do this. And then boom, 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 boom. Okay, so then I'm going to loop forever. Okay, so now the timer's off and running. We're just hitting in the main loop. Every time the counter time counts up and reaches this value, it will do two things. Number one, it'll set a flag, and we can use that to trigger an interrupt, which we set up right here. And then it's also going to roll back over to zero and start counting because we're in up mode. So now we're ready to leave the main program and come down here, and I'm ready to enter an interrupt service routine. So I'm gonna come down and put a little header here, this is ISRs, and I'm gonna tell the compiler, hey, get ready, compiler. I am now initializing the vector table. Which vector address would you like to initialize, sir? How about timer0_B0_vector? Now you're like, whoa, where'd that come from? Well, if you recall, that's this, all right? That is the vector address label for this TB0CCR0 interrupt. So it has its own dedicated one. So this is going in a different spot. All right, life is good. Well, the starting address of the following routine is going to be put into this vector location, but we need to tell it that this routine is not like a regular subroutine. It is a interrupt service routine. And so I'm going to call it ISR TB0 CCR0. And let's not put anything in it or return anything. And this little __ interrupt, what it did was it told this thing, hey, return from this routine with RETI, please. If you do it with RET, your computer will crash. All right, so we're here. What are we trying to do? All right, does anyone remember? We're in the interrupt service routine. We're going to toggle LED1. So I'm going to say P1 out, and then I'm going to toggle bit 0. So this is toggle LED1. That's why we came here. And now, what else should we do? You got to clear that flag. Because the only reason you got here was because that flag triggered and sent this interrupt service handler to go get the address and put the program counter down here, and now you do this. If you don't clear that flag, guess what? It's going to immediately trigger again, and you're going to get stuck. But luckily, I have the code for it right there. Okay, holy smokes, that's a lot of counting, a lot of typing. Let's go ahead and flush out our syntax errors. It has been a while since we've not had a syntax error, but we're getting fast at finding them, I guess. Okay, line 13. And, oh, look at that. I'm always forgetting it right there. Weird. Okay. No big deal. Compiler's our friend. Okay, so, go. Good. Okay, so it's time to look at the board. And so I got my, here is LED1. And I'm going to have a stopwatch next to it because this is supposed to be a half a second. So the LED should come on half a second, go off for a half a second. So this should be at a period of, you know, it's 1 hertz, right? I mean, it's on half, off half. So let's just go for it. Let's see if this even blinks. Boom. Look at it. Yes. Yes. Okay. So it's blinking. Now I'm going to try to do this awesome timing measurement here. So as soon as it comes on, I'm going to hit go. It's pretty dang close, right? So it's pretty dang close to being, every time it comes on, it turns on it right as soon as it flips over another second. So it's turning on for half a second, turning off for half a second. It's pretty good. That's a, you know, and it's, we're trying to measure it with a stopwatch. So it's not super accurate. If I really wanted to see how accurate it was, I'd do it with an oscilloscope. But look at that. That's awesome. We did it. So check this out. You set up a timer compare, and you use the timer compare to generate an interrupt at a time of our choosing. So we chose 0.5 seconds. We were no longer bound by the 2 to the end kind of stuff that you get when you just use the timer overflow. So awesome. Congratulations. You should feel very good about yourself right now. All right. As always, remember, support my channel by subscribing, and goodbye.